Am I audible? So we start this session, and to who else to start it from? Considering the rate of dropout in the state, or maybe considering the number of students who are there in schools and colleges, I'd like to ask you, Minister Sahab, agla plan of action hai kya? 17 saal to ho gaye sarkar ko. Phir bhi bachche school ja rahe hain, khush hain aap?
खुश हूँ। 17 साल में अगर आप देखेंगे उड़ीसा में जितना एसटीएससी डिपार्टमेंट उड़ीसा में स्कूल एंड मास और एसटीएससी डिपार्टमेंट दोनों के डिपार्टमेंट में बच्चे स्कूल में जाते हैं, अगर देखा जाए तो ऑल इंडिया लेवल में अगर देखेंगे उड़ीसा में 6000 हॉस्टल उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट ने बनाया है, इसमें 6 लाख से बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं। और उड़ीसा में जितना पोस्ट मैट्रिक स्कॉलरशिप और प्री मैट्रिक स्कॉलरशिप हमारा बजट उड़ीसा में है 1000 करोड़। इसमें अगर देखेंगे उड़ीसा में जितना ड्रॉप आउट अब कम हो गया है, उड़ीसा में ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा सारा इंडिया लेवल में अगर हम देखेंगे उड़ीसा में इतना हॉस्टल उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट ने हमारा चीफ मिनिस्टर नवीन जी ने इतना हॉस्टल खुलवाया है एसटीएससी डिपार्टमेंट में, सारा भारत में कौन सा स्टेट में भी आप नहीं देखेंगे उड़ीसा में जितना है। तो हर तरफ से अन्वेषा एक स्कीम उड़ीसा में हुआ है, अन्वेषा एक स्कीम, इसमें अन्वेषा स्कीम में स्टैंडर्ड 1 से स्टैंडर्ड 2 तक उड़ीसा में 25,000 बच्चे को सीबीएसई कोर्स में एक नया स्कीम बनाया है उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट 2015-16 में। इसमें देखा जाए तो 13,000 स्टूडेंट्स उड़ीसा में पढ़ रहे हैं सीबीएसई कोर्स में, एसटी का बच्चे 75% पढ़ रहे हैं और 25% एससी का बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं। तो देखा जाए तो ड्रॉप आउट जितना रेट था पहले अब कम हो गया है, उड़ीसा में ज्यादा से ज्यादा एसटीएससी बच्चे स्कूल जा रहे हैं।
स्कूल जाने की बात जब करते हैं तो जाने के लिए ही कई किलोमीटर चलना पड़ता है, बच्चे जाना ही नहीं चाहते हैं क्योंकि सबसे बड़ी दिक्कत यही होती है कि इतना दूर है हमारा स्कूल कि हम जब तक पहुंचेंगे तब तक वापस आने का समय हो जाता है।
उड़ीसा में तो अगर देखेंगे
डिस्टेंस
एक किलोमीटर में एक स्कूल है, उड़ीसा में 1 किलोमीटर में एक स्कूल है, इसीलिए बच्चे को दिक्कत नहीं हो रहा है। जितना बच्चे पहले जैसे 5 किलोमीटर 6 किलोमीटर जाना पड़ता था, अभी 1 किलोमीटर में एक स्कूल हो गया है।
स्कूल की बात करें लेकिन व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट स्कूल्स, KISS हैज सेट अ वर्ल्ड एग्जाम्पल, हाउ डू यू प्लान टू टेक इट फॉरवर्ड नाउ बिकॉज नाउ यू साइनिंग MOUs इन वेरियस स्टेट्स, so will that give the same benefit to the tribal students in the state across other states also?
Yeah ma'am, you are very right. The KISS Kalinga Social Science has created landmark in imparting education to the poor children, that's true. And now as people are very much interested to have the branch of this KISS in different districts of Odisha and also different states, I am on this process and it is very nicely going on. Now I have the plan and already work started to set up the branch of KISS in minimum 10 districts of Odisha by next year, and it will be functional with the help of the others people. And recently we have signed MOU in the West Bengal with one NGO, that one branch of KISS will be coming in West Bengal as you have been asking me several times. And similarly the branch of KISS will be coming in many other states as it has been accepted as the most successful model. As you are asking just now, Honorable Minister, your dropout is zero and everything is so nice. So 15 states are very much interested, they had a nice discussion, it is a time constraint. Definitely in the coming years this school education will be spreading like anything.
The stress level is also on the gender comparison, if I may ask you. On the gender comparison makes it very difficult, especially the fact that language, what we were discussing, that for tribals, language is a major issue, and that is why they don't want to continue in the same school because of the language. Yes.
I am associated with an organization which is working in the field of improving quality of education in tribal areas. Hmm. And our experience has shown that in tribal areas, for many tribal children, ODI is a foreign language. So many of them actually drop out because they find it extremely difficult to understand textbooks written in Odia. So what we have done, or our volunteers have done, they try to teach tribal children through their mother tongue, through tribal languages, up to class 3. And then slowly they graduate into studying textbooks and their courses through their own language, so through Odia. So we very often forget that for many tribal children, Odia is a foreign language that they don't understand, and texts written in Odia remain inaccessible to them, and they drop out. So this has considerably reduced the dropout rate in many tribal schools, particularly in Mayurbhanj and in southern Odisha. So in some schools where we're conducting this experiment. So that's one.
If I may ask you, sir, what is the number of authors has been reducing when it comes to Odia books per se? Is that something that would be also impacting the education vis-a-vis development?
See, the topic for today, you know, is education, you know, drives development. You know, that I think everybody sitting in this hall will agree that for any development, you know, education is the key. And it's said that if you want to finish a nation, finish the education. I'll little digress from your question. You know, I know everybody sitting here knows this, but at the cost of reputation, probably India was one of the leading countries of the world, say 1,000 years ago, and Odisha was on the seat of knowledge probably in the 3rd century itself with Pushpagiri here, and 400 years back Odisha was probably, 300 years back Odisha was one of the leading eastern states in trade and commerce. So there is a direct link between education and development. Having said that, your question, coming to your question that whether, you know, authors, reading, and, you know, development, whether it's correlated. Of course it's correlated, but more than that, what's the education? Is education just scoring marks? Is a question of education of learning, or education for for learning? Is very, very crucial. What we need to know, as per the, you know, World Bank study on the survey of World Education Report, the focus is on three aspects. One is educate early, educate smart, and educate all. And that's what, that's how you can, you know, improve any country and the world in general. In what, in the first is educate early means it's school education. So every country or every state has to probably focus more into school education. Educate smart, that the second World Bank, you know, strategy is, you have to provide quality education, you know. Meaning of quality education means, you know, the education standards should not be assessed on the basis of the inputs, but on the basis of the output, you know, how it's going to help. And how the state is empowering you know, providing quality education to all. But, you know, that's how probably, you know, education drives development.
But we talk about schools, Majhi Saab, give me an idea. Are we talking about schools that they are the best in class? We still don't have good primary schools, and that's where the mind, young minds are made. You will be a graduate when you are interested in schooling in primary and school education. If you back out then, there's no future at all. How difficult is that?
Odisha mein bhi hai acha school abhi bhi hai. Odisha mein Odisha government mein bhi acha school banaya hai. Isliye
Nayak Saab, aap agree karenge isko?
Unka
नहीं, 15 साल नहीं,
17 साल का,
15
years. नहीं, 17 साल के
अच्छा
नहीं, 17 साल हमारा जो ओडिशा में हमारा जो गवर्नमेंट है, इसमें अगर देखा जाए तो प्राइमरी एजुकेशन को अभी डेवलपमेंट हो गया है. इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर पहले नहीं था, आज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर हो गया है. कुछ टीचर्स नहीं थे, अभी टीचर्स हो गए हैं, आगे हैं. इसीलिए उड़ीसा प्राइमरी एजुकेशन में थोड़ा आगे चल रहा है. अभी
जब बात करते हैं हम लोग राष्ट्रीय साक्षरता मिशन की और बाकी सारे जितने भी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के प्रोग्राम्स हैं, उनके हिसाब से उड़ीसा कहीं ना कहीं पिछड़ जाता है. उसके लिए आपको लगता है कि क्या केंद्र सरकार को और ज्यादा काम करना चाहिए, या सिर्फ राज्य सरकार के लिए जो कर रही है वो काफी है?
नहीं, दोनों सरकार, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया को भी करना पड़ेगा और स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को भी करना पड़ेगा. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का हम देखेंगे, हमारा डिपार्टमेंट में अगर देखेंगे, हमारा डिपार्टमेंट में जो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ही ज्यादा हमारा बजट में रख रहे हैं इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट के लिए. हमारा जितना स्कूल है, गवर्नमेंट इंडिया जो दे रहा था पैसे पहले जो SCLO TSP आर्टिकल 275(1) में जो जो STS डिपार्टमेंट को जो आ रहा था 2013-14 से थोड़ा कम हो रहा है उड़ीसा में, इसीलिए स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ने खुद का बजट बनाया है। उड़ीसा का जगह STSC डिपार्टमेंट का बजट देखेंगे 3000 करोड़ हो गया है उड़ीसा का बजट, इसीलिए इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को थोड़ा हम डेवलपमेंट कर रहे हैं। स्कूल जितना सारे जो स्कूल था पहले अच्छा स्कूल नहीं था, अभी स्कूल
टीचर्स की कमी हमेशा रहती है राज्य
टीचर्स की कमी तो कुछ जगह में थे अभी भी
काफी है।
हाँ, कुछ है, कोशिश कर रहे हैं उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि उसको कैसे फुलफिल किया जाए, हमारा कोशिश रहता है इसमें।
तो प्राइवेट स्कूल पे ज्यादा डिपेंडेंस हो जाती है इसकी वजह से?
नहीं नहीं, प्राइवेट गवर्नमेंट स्कूल में अगर देखा जाए उड़ीसा में हमारा हॉस्टल में 5.5 लाख तो हमारा हॉस्टल में ही STSC बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं, अगर देखेंगे 20 लाख तो हम स्टाइपेंड दे रहे हैं हमारा डिपार्टमेंट, इसीलिए ज्यादा से ज्यादा प्राइवेट स्कूल को ही चूज रहे हैं। हम अभी कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा CBSE कोर्स में थोड़ा स्कूल STSC बच्चे को कैसे दिया जाए, इसीलिए बरहमपुर में भी एक 3000 स्टूडेंट्स के लिए अभी एक मेगा एजुकेशन कॉम्प्लेक्स भी बना रहे हैं, इसमें 6th स्टैंडर्ड से 12th स्टैंडर्ड तक भी पढ़ेंगे।
सो गिव मी एन आइडिया, हाउ डिफिकल्ट इज इट टू कोरिलेट डेवलपमेंट एंड एजुकेशन? इज इट कोरिलेटेड? How is it intermingled with each other when it comes to being on the same page yet on a different tangent?
There is no doubt that both are interlinked, as Mr. Sahoo was telling. Before getting to your question, I want to add one thing. You see, we cannot blame the present regime for everything that is bad happening. Tarab, even though Mr. Sahoo was telling about Pushpagiri, Bihar, which is also equivalent to, which compared to Nalanda and Takshashila. But we should not forget that the historical regions, Odisha got its first university after almost 90 years of Calcutta University. When there were colleges and colleges in neighboring states, Odisha had only one or two primary schools and one or two collegiate school, I mean intermediate. So there were historical reasons why this we are lagging behind. But compared to that, we are fortunate that at least we are sharing seats with Mr. Samanta and Mr. Sahoo, who have set up two international schools, SAI International Schools and KIT International Schools. So there is no doubt, because unless there is education, what is education? Education only is there for the skill development. This is like a lifeblood. If there is no education, no skill, so we cannot do anything. And so now things are improving. You are right when saying that.
What is the biggest challenge when you say improvement? It's a big word. It's a huge word. Improvement can be in any way. Sadak kharab thi, marammat karai, that is also improvement. What is the specific improvement we are looking forward when it comes to education?
You see, your advice. I don't think when we are talking about that, now the students are going to public schools. They are not going to government schools. This is not the only phenomenon in Odisha. Everywhere in India, even the poor clerk, he is not interested to send his kid to government school. Why that is, that's a very long story. Because he wants his kid to be smart, to be employable, and to earn money, to get into computer, so many things. So that is everywhere. Even that is, the Odisha is no exception.
Majhi sahab, can I bring you in on this debate? Because मेरे को समझ नहीं आता कि उन्होंने कहा कि private school में भेजना चाहते हैं क्योंकि सब अपने बच्चों को smart बनाना चाहते हैं। सरकारी स्कूल में बच्चे स्मार्ट क्यों नहीं हो पाते हैं? ये सवाल ऐसा क्यों हर जगह आ जाता है?
नहीं, सरकारी स्कूल में भी बच्चे अच्छे स्मार्ट हो रहे हैं। अगर आप देखेंगे जो हमारे डिपार्टमेंट में कुछ एजुकेशनल कॉम्प्लेक्स है, उड़ीसा में जो कुछ PBTG है, जो आदिम जनजाति जो है, डंगरिया कंदे है, के बंडा है, कुछ डिडाए है, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा उड़ीसा में जितना सारे जो प्रिमिटिव ट्राइब्स हैं उनका एजुकेशन अगर देखेंगे तो स्कूल एंड हमारा डिपार्टमेंट में STSC डिपार्टमेंट में ही वो पढ़ रहे हैं। और अच्छा रिजल्ट करे, एसएससी जो मैट्रिक जो जो एग्जाम हो रहा है इसमें भी उनका 80% 90% वो रख रहे हैं, रिजल्ट हो रहा है।
तो ऐसा क्यों होता है कि जो कीट और किस में पढ़ते हैं वो इंटरनेशनल चले जाते हैं, जो सरकारी स्कूल में होते हैं वो नहीं जा पाते?
नहीं, कीट और किस में भी पढ़ रहे हैं हमारा जो एसटीएससी बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं, मैं तो अच्युत सामंत जी को धन्यवाद दूंगा।
उनके तो 25,000 बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं, विदेश चले जाते हैं, वो इंटरनेशनल मेडल ले आते हैं, सरकारी स्कूल के 5 बच्चे ऐसे क्यों नहीं निकलते हैं जो कहते हैं कि हम इस सरकारी स्कूल से निकले हैं?
नहीं ना, सरकारी स्कूल से भी बच्चे मेडल ले रहे हैं और विदेश भी जा रहे हैं, और उनका तो भुवनेश्वर में जितना किस का स्टूडेंट जितना पढ़ रहे हैं वो भी तो जा रहे हैं हमारे डिपार्टमेंट।
आपके आंकड़ों से मिलते हैं इनके आंकड़े?
आफ्टर ऑल हम लोग का केस एक डिफरेंट केस है, इट इज ए टोटली डिफरेंट वर्ल्ड गेम। यहाँ एक पैशन में आदमी लोग काम करते हैं, पीपल आर वर्किंग विथ ए पैशन, दैट्स वाई दिस चिल्ड्रेन आर एक्सेलिंग लाइक एनीथिंग। इन केस ऑफ गवर्नमेंट व्हाट मिनिस्टर विल डू, इट इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ द कंसर्न टीचर्स एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स वगैरह। एंड व्हाट एवर यू आर आस्किंग जस्ट बिफोर दिस, व्हाट इज द इम्प्रूवमेंट हैज टेकन प्लेस इन द लास्ट फ्यू ईयर्स एटसेट्रा, गौरवी दास जी आस्किंग। इफ यू सी देर इज ए सी चेंज इन एजुकेशन इन द स्टेट ऑफ ओडिशा एंड पर्टिकुलरली भुवनेश्वर कैपिटल सिटी। Now all the policy makers will agree or they are discussing, Bhubaneswar has become the education hub in eastern part of India. Before 15-20 years, thousands of students or children were going to different states to pursue the education. Now the thousands of students are coming to Bhubaneswar. Now more than 2 lakh young mass from the entire India are staying in Bhubaneswar to get the education. And Bhubaneswar has become in real sense the education hub. So this is the change has taken place in education in the state of Odisha, and many more will definitely take place later part of the definitely it will take place coming years.
I borrow the famous phrase from America, change has come to Odisha.
Yeah, definitely. It has become the most happening state, most vibrant city.
So private universities, academies and sarkari mein, what happens to be the biggest challenge and the interpersonal skills that they gain more in private or non-government schooling?
See, there is nothing called as private or public as far as education is concerned, because education deals with knowledge and skill, right? So there cannot be a differentiation that knowledge and skill imparting to the children is different in government schools, different in public institutions, and different in private schools. I fully agree what Dr. Achuyta Samanta said, that some of the private institutions, I will not say all the private institutions, some of the private institutions do work passionately and see to that more of knowledge and skill is imparted to these children. But here we should not forget, India is such a large country. Almost 85% of the school education, because I belong to school education, I am not dealing now with the higher education. So the school education, 85% of the infrastructure or the school education is controlled by government, and that's the fundamental right. Only 15% is probably with the private sector. So the primary responsibility definitely is with the government institutions. However, if you see in the urban areas or semi-urban areas, the demand is, as you rightly stated, the demand is that people want more, people want to go to the private school. So what has happened? There is a 40% demand on the private schools in the semi-urban and urban areas. So this has brought a, scarcity for which probably I feel government, both state government and central government, should come up with more of access through private education and make the procedure such, because school education is, I think, probably one of the sectors which is very, very, very highly regulated. You know, every aspect of the school education is regulated. So here comes that we have to increase the availability so that competition automatically increases, education becomes affordable, and the quality improves.
When you talk about quality of education, the gender gap is around 19% in Odisha. So that also creates a lot of problem with basic sanitation facilities in school. Do you have, in Sikshasandhan, you've studied a lot, you've done a lot of research. Does it happen that the gender, because of being a female, they drop out more from schools because they don't get the basic sanitation facilities? And how should the government move ahead on it?
Yeah, I think the government has a role which cannot be actually ignored. I think government is the most important player in this field. For instance, if you think of the link between development and education, think of the two major education acts in the world. One is the 1870 Act in Britain, which introduced compulsory education, and it transformed Britain, 1870. And then around the same time, 1872, Japan, 1872 or 1870 Education Act, that transformed. So you can't have world-class universities and very third-class primary school education. You can't imagine development without introducing compulsory education, and without that you will create only victims of development, all these. So yes, girls are dropping out of schools because of lack of sanitation facilities. But you have to address the problem at a much larger level. You can't only think of world-class universities and not world-class primary schools or world-class secondary school education. So
that brings me to the question of Arakshan. Arakshan se kitne fayde, kitne nuksan? Aur kya aapko lagta hai ki jo bachcha ek certain level tak padh kar aa raha hai, wo suddenly ek dusre level par aakar baith jayega, to kya usi level par kabhi barabar aa payega? Kitna mushkil hai aur kitna aasan hai?
Nahi, Arakshan to ek kuch logo ko to Arakshan chahiye. जितना ये तो गवर्नमेंट तो बना है आरक्षण, कुछ एसटी एससी और ओबीसी माइनॉरिटी सब लोगों के तो कुछ आरक्षण रहता है. इसीलिए आरक्षण तो अगर नहीं रहेंगे तो थोड़ा एसटी एससी बच्चे को थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम जरूर होगा. उसको कैसे स्टेट गवर्नमेंट हो या गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया कैसे उनका अच्छा रिजर्वेशन दे और एसटी एससी बच्चे कैसे अच्छा पढ़े उनका स्टेट गवर्नमेंट और गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का.
गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया की बात करते हैं तो पूरे सहयोगिता मिल रही है आपको? खुश हैं आप अभी?
गवर्नमेंट
क्योंकि पांच साल पहले अभी इसी सरकार से खुश थे.
नहीं, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया जितना हम सोचते हैं, उड़ीसा जितना सोचता है, इतना नहीं दे रहे हैं. पैसा दे रहे हैं जितना अच्छा हम मिलना चाहिए था 2013-14 से. मैं तो बोल रहा था कि 2013-14 से दो स्कीम में एससीए टू टीएसपी और आर्टिकल 275(1) में ट्राइबल अफेयर्स डिपार्टमेंट जितना पैसा उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट को देना चाहिए था, इतना उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट नहीं.
केंद्र सरकार, आपके ट्राइबल मिनिस्टर आप ही के राज्य से हैं, ज्वालोराम साहब.
नहीं, मैं किसी को
आप जाकर
उड़ीसा का ही, जो ज्वालोराम जी उड़ीसा का ही है, मगर
देते नहीं पैसे आपको.
नहीं, जितना देते हैं, जितना हम हमारा हक है, इतना हम नहीं पा रहे हैं उड़ीसा.
अधिकार मांगने जाएंगे आप?
जरूर, हम तो बोल रहे हैं. उड़ीसा सीएम नवीन जी ने भी बार बार उनको बोल रहे हैं, फिर भी उड़ीसा जितना हमारा मिलना चाहिए
था. सुनती नहीं है सरकार, मतलब केंद्र सरकार आपकी भी नहीं सुनती है, मंत्रियों के आपकी नहीं सुनती है?
नहीं, सुन रहे हैं. जितना हम बोल रहे हैं, जितना हम मिलना चाहिए था, इतना नहीं मिल रहा है. अगर आप देखेंगे 2013-14 से जितना तो कुछ दिन एक पेपर कटिंग में आया था कि 1500 करोड़ उड़ीसा में 3 साल में मिल रहा है. 3 साल में 1500 करोड़ नहीं मिला, 814 करोड़ ही मिला है उड़ीसा को. ऐसा भी वो बोल रहे हैं.
देखिए, वादे दावे ऐसे ऐसे झूठे हो जाते हैं कि अब आप खुद ही कह रहे हैं कि 1500 बोले, 800 दिए.
हाँ, वो तो हमारे पास रिकॉर्ड है, उड़ीसा में 814 करोड़ ही मिला है 3 साल में. वो बोल रहे हैं कि मीडिया में उनका एक मीटिंग भी था, वहाँ बोल रहे हैं कि 1500 करोड़ उड़ीसा को मिला है, उड़ीसा खर्चा कर नहीं पा रहा है. उड़ीसा जितना पैसा मिला है, हम उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट यूसी हम लोग दे रहे हैं उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट तरफ से.
मिस्टर दास, गिव मी एन आइडिया, ये पॉलिटिक्स में फंस कर व्हाट इज द फेट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स देन, वेयर डज इट गो? बिकॉज वन आफ्टर द अदर द ब्लेम गेम समहाउ कंटिन्यूज इन दिस.
वी आर इन डेमोक्रेसी, वी कैनॉट इग्नोर पॉलिटिक्स, बट दिस इज ऑल्सो ट्रू दैट उड़ीसा हैज बीन विक्टिमाइज. यू सी, आई थिंक टिल 2000 देर वॉज नो IIT, नो IIMs, नो Niger, नथिंग ऑफ दैट सर्ट. थैंक्स टू सम प्राइवेट एंटरप्रेनर्स, दे पुट अप सेट अप सम इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेजेस. आई विल टेल यू वन थिंग, लेट अस कंपेयर विद केरला. व्हेन केरला दोज विजनरी पॉलिटिशियन दे डिसाइडेड दे शुड पुट अप सम नर्सिंग स्कूल्स एंड टाइप राइटिंग इंस्टीट्यूट, स्टेनोग्राफर्स. यू कैन फाइंड ए मलयालम स्टेनोग्राफर एवरी हर यू गो, एंड ऑल्सो नर्स. The people who had exposed to, who are exposed to typewriter, they were also got the benefit of computer. And the North Stars, you can find all of them in Middle East and Western countries. So we have Odisha now, we have more than 100, close to 100 engineering colleges, but we were late. I think we should, if we could have put up this engineering college 20 years back, 20 years earlier, things would have been different. Now we are struggling for medical colleges. But look at Andhra, look at Maharashtra, look at Karnataka. They have plenty of medical colleges and engineering colleges. So I think Odisha, government of India have also, I think they have felt in the helping Odisha the way they should have.
The way should have. But is it always the private sector that has to take the lead? May I ask Mr. Samanta about it? That okay, you have decided that you will set up a kit and a case and that's the reason. You had an IMC coming here but never made the mark.
You see, there was a time when government was the main player. Now the time has come in the 21st century, it should be only private player. Because private player...
I hope Mr. Majhi is listening this.
So, that's why if you see the entire world, any country where the education plays the important role, that is by the private sector. So, when the India got independence, etc., there was no private player and government came out and they set up IIT, NIT, all these things good, it is very nice. But now there are thousands of private players are coming up. So, they should be encouraged to set up the high-class institute and the problem will be solved.
Does the problem solve with high-class institute? Because you need fees. You need to pay the fees. If you don't have that level of income, how can you afford a school of that stature at the end of the day? No, I'm asking Mr. Nayak.
No, I don't think the private sector can play the role which government can play in the field of education, because even today, in spite of all the private players being very active in the educational sector, every year in the matriculation exam, you have 6.5 lakh students sitting for the high school examination.
Exactly.
So how many private schools are producing that kind of? And as I told you, without the Education Act, so government creates conditions in which private players can flourish. Without the government, without government taking a very active initiative in the field of education, private players cannot take the situation very far.
We have a lot of students here. Would any of the students would like to ask the minister on where and what do they see their fate forward to? I'm just wondering, is everyone confident being a graduate or a master's? Here you are sure for a job letter coming in your hand very soon. Or does that worry you despite the degree? Naukri kaise milegi? No questions? I'm amazed. Well, there's one student who wants to ask.
This was Odisha is happy.
Huh?
This was Odisha is happy.
Yeah, no, the second issue can be language also at times that we've seen. Some of them are not comfortable or hesitant.
Good afternoon. I am a student from Birla Global University. My question is for Mr. Bijoy Kumar Sahoo. Sir, as you mentioned that education should not be assessed on the basis of input but rather output. So if the quality input is not there, as in if you see in, especially in Odisha, I would say that there are no quality inputs in government schools. Like in rural areas, you can say there is a ratio of 1:187 teacher-student ratio in primary schools. So if the students are not properly oriented with proper knowledge and skill, then why would they prefer government school, and what the government has been doing about it, and what would be your opinion?
Good question, but your question has many parts and many aspects, so I'll try to answer as much as possible. You said, you know, why it should be output-based, why it should not be input-based, right? So, but you go to a hotel and you ask for a good food and the restaurant says that I have put all these things, you know, I have put the best quality rice, I put the best quality oil, I put the best quality cooking gas, everything best. But when you eat the food, you know, you can't even test it, you take it inside. So will you go to the restaurant next time? So India, after independence, we have been approving, sanctioning, licensing, everything on input. However, as you said, you know, in a developing economy, input also matters because we need to ensure minimum standard, right? However, I feel we have now come to a stage, even after 75 years of independence, if we still say that we have to be input-based, when the world over, the assessment is on output-based, then we cannot compete with the world. This is the first area. The second part of the question was, you know, in the rural areas, when the basic facilities are not there, you know, how do you make it output based? There, actually output based is more important, because there we have to see some of these bright students on the basis of the output based, so how they can be uplifted, how their knowledge and skill can be taken to the next level. Two good interventions Odisha government has done. One is this Adarsh Mahavidyalaya, where the students are going to be selected, and the students who have skills and who have the adequate knowledge on the basis of the entrance exams will be taken into these 314 schools which are coming in, one in each block. So Odisha government probably has taken, this is one of the best things that government could have done to give a quality example. Like I'll tell you, I was talking of the access to education. Until Government of India took out the regulation from automobiles, we were not having access or privy to good vehicles, good four-wheelers. We were still with this Ambassador and Fiat. Now, the availability has to be there. Now, if you create such institutions in the government level, CBSE, 314, one in each block, and benchmark them, and try to uplift also other schools, other government schools to that level, that is what I meant by output matching.
So output and input, Majhi sahab, kab theek hoga ye? 2 saal bache hain agle chunav mein.
नहीं नहीं चुनाव जब भी होगा इस बारे में हम उसमें नहीं सोचते हैं कि चुनाव तो आएगा और चुनाव जाएगा उसमें हमारा बात नहीं
है. बच्चे होंगे जो 18 साल के हो जाएंगे, नए वोटर जुड़ जाएंगे.
नहीं, हमारा उम्मीद है कि कैसे नवीन जी ने जितना ओडिशा का जो दायित्व ले गए, ओडिशा देखेंगे तो 7-8 साल में ज़्यादा अच्छा काम हो रहा है. एजुकेशन सेक्टर में अगर देखेंगे तो अच्छा काम हुआ है, इसमें तो ज्यादा फायदा भी बच्चे उनको भी मिल रहा है उड़ीसा में.
मिस्टर दास, वुड यू लाइक टू ऐड टू द फायदा एंड द बेनिफिट? व्हाट मिस्टर साहू डिड नॉट ऐड टू द प्लैटर वाज नमक, एंड नमक इज ऑलवेज स्वादानुसार.
आई डोंट वांट टू कम बिटवीन मिस्टर साहू एंड मिनिस्टर साहब, बट आई थिंक ऑल द टाइम ओडिशा गवर्नमेंट कैन नॉट गो ऑन ब्लेमिंग सेंटर. दे शुड हैव ऑल्सो इनिशिएटिव एंड पैशन, because they are the people. The people have Odisha have elected them. They cannot wash their hands off. I think there should be passion, and the Adarsh school which we are talking about, they are on CBSE syllabus. They should be completed and taken care of in a earnest.
Well, that's what we would like to sum it up with. Vidya Dadati Vinayam, when you translate the Sanskrit phrase into Hindi or English, it states that brilliance comes only with education. Rather, that is where you get discipline also from. So we'll have to wrap it up with the fact that education would be the most important wheel forward in the road to development of the great grand state, Odisha. Thanks to everyone for being a wonderful panel, taking us forward on the state of the roadmap.